Hello everyone, and welcome to a very quick video. Apologies that my voice may sound a little off. I've managed to catch a cold. Today we are going to have a quick look at using the Meta XR simulator together with Godot, and seeing how quick and easy it is to set this up. Links as always are in the description of the video. You can download the simulator from the Meta website from this page. Meta will ask you to agree to their terms. Inside of the zip file we've downloaded, we find a TGZ file. We simply copy that to extract it. Now we right-click on this file and select Extract All, and press Extract. We now find a folder with our simulator. Inside of that, we find a folder called Package. And inside of that, you find a folder called Meta XR Simulator. This folder is all you need, so you can copy that into a more permanent place. But for our demonstration today, I will use it as is. Switching to Godot, we can see that we are using Godot 4.3 Beta 1 here. I have also loaded the demo project that comes with Godot XR Tools. To set up the simulator, we need to open the editor menu and select Editor Settings. Now we scroll down until we find our OpenXR settings. Here we find an option called Runtime Paths. Click on where it says Dictionary to expand this. We are going to add the XR simulator to this list. We can see a couple of existing entries, but the UI to add a new entry is somewhat finicky. We click on the pen button on the new key line and select String. Now we can give our entry a name. We'll call this Meta XR Simulator. Next we click on the pen button on the new value line and again select String. Now we need the path to our simulator. For this I'm going back to our Windows Explorer and find the Meta OpenXR Simulator JSON file. We right-click on this and select Copy as Path. Now back in Godot, we can paste our path into our entry box. We do need to remove the quotes that Windows Explorer added. Now we click on the Add Key Value Pair button and our entry is added to the list. Last but not least, we click on Save and Restart. When we open our OpenXR Runtime drop-down menu from the top right, we can now see that our simulator has been added to this list. The contents of this list may vary for you, as it will filter by installed runtimes. We can select our simulator, and now we can run our application using the Play button. We can see that the simulator starts up. Now I'm not going to give a full demonstration of the simulator. However, in order to follow our instructions here, we simply click and hold the left mouse button on our viewport. The left mouse button will simulate the trigger of the currently selected controller. We can now use WASD to move around. And we can look around by holding the right mouse button and moving our mouse. The simulator has many more powerful features, so just explore around. It is a great way to test your application without having to use your headset. If you found this information useful, please consider liking the video. And while you're there, might as well hit the subscribe button. It really helps my channel. If you want to support me more directly, consider becoming a member of the channel. See you next time!